I made a title sequence for a film, so in this video, I show you how to do that. Alright, so the sequence is actually pretty simple. The key is a lot of smaller pieces that come together to make the overall effect. So let's break each of those down. Now the backdrop for this effect is a time-lapse I shot of clouds going over the Blue Mound, which is the subject of my documentary, but I wanted it a lot more stylized than that. So the first thing we're going to do is take the background layer and duplicate it twice, so we have three copies of the same layer. We're going to disable the bottom two layers for now and focus on the top one. First thing we'll do is put a Luma key on. This will allow us to key out the brighter parts of the image, leaving just the hill and the trees. Next, we'll throw on some curves to darken that layer, then a tint to make the outline of the hill stand out a bit. Now let's go over to the next layer. On this one, we're going to apply a Red Giant Universe texturize effect, which will add a bit of texture to our clouds. I used the cracked wall texture at a 75% scale, then set the blend mode to cutout. We'll also set the tint to a nice shade of blue. That gives us a good amount of color and texture, but it's a bit too aggressive, which is where our last layer comes in. First, we're going to set the top sky layer to have an opacity of 20%. That brings down the intensity, but you can't really see the clouds, so we're going to put an aggressive luminance curve on it to really increase the contrast and make the clouds more visible. Now for the title part of this title sequence. This is actually pretty simple, but it involves a lot of sub-compositions. First, we'll create a composition just for the main title. In this case, it's the Blue Mound, using the Alpha Slab 1 font as well as another instance of Universe Texturize and a brightness plugin to bring up the brightness. Now we'll create a title composition and bring in our main text composition. This is so we can animate and move the text while having our text texture move with the text. That's so many texts, I feel like a teenage girl. Now we can do a simple animation with vertical motion and opacity to have the text slide into view, and of course enable motion blur to make everything look nice and smooth. Next, we'll create another subcomp with a box. Since a box by itself is pretty boring, we'll tweak that to have just the stroke and no fill, then throw on the same texturize and brightness effects we used on our main text so they match. Then we'll throw that composition onto our title sequence, then animate it to slide around as our text pops up. Just for kicks, we can create another composition with some sub-information, in this case, the latitude, longitude, and altitude of the Blue Mound. Throw on the same effects as all of our other title elements, then animate it to slide into view, then we just throw our subtext into the main title with some animation and speed timing tweaks, we have a finished title. Then we can just throw our main title onto our time-lapse backdrop, and we're just about finished. The last thing I did is put an adjustment layer between our title and the background layers and animate a blur using the fast blur effect that goes in time with the title. This is to create some separation between the text and the background as the text appears. And now we have a finished and beautiful title sequence. Anyway, that's it for this video. If this video helped you to learn a bit more about After Effects and how you can use some of the effects and some other third-party plugins to create different title sequences or whatever type of titles you want to create, hit that like button. If not, feel free to hit the dislike button. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. And if you want to see more videos like this, please hit that subscribe button.